I Can't Drive 55, entering the countdown at number 20. Sammy's 3 weeks into his North American tour right now, and the band that's opening for him, Crocus, debuts this week at number 19.
Last year we played with the Leopards, you know, and blew them away. And Sammy Hagar was, you know, when we started 1980, the first shows ever in America was with Sammy Hagar. So it's a reunion, it's a great package.
Midnight Maniac coming into the countdown at 19. Crocus and Sammy are taking a few days off, but the tour resumes Sunday night in Evansville, Indiana. After peaking at number 3 a few weeks ago, Huey Lewis and the News fall from 9 to number 18 with If This... Right after this, 3 video songs from female artists, including Madonna, who has no apologies for her image.
I'm not ashamed to admit it.
Ever feel like getting away from it all? This summer, take your vacation on MTV.
I want to break free.
The beach. The farms. The big cities. The desert. The road. MTV Music Television. All your favorite music from all your favorite places all summer long. The MTV Top 20 Video Countdown.
Bananarama have done 3 videos for their second album, Robert De Niro's Waiting, Rough Justice, and the video song that slips from 16 to 17 this week, Cruel Summer. Even though Tina Turner probably won't be back in the studio to work on her next album until January, she does appear on David Bowie's new album singing the title track tonight. Tina's first number one song in the States, What's Love Got to Do with It, is down from 12 to 16 on the countdown. Video song number 15 is by Madonna, who admits that sex has a lot to do with the image that she's created. 2 weeks ago on the MTV Awards show, she gave us a preview of her next song, Like a Virgin. Even though sex appeal has worked for her, Madonna's got her share of critics.
Every once in a while I get a reaction from another performer who's a feminist, a singer. And if I do get anything from them, I think it's really, I think they're just, they're jealous and envious of me. And my reply to them is that that's the choice that I've made. I don't, you know, I'm not going to tell you what to do with your life, and you're not going to tell me what to do with mine. I enjoy this. I'm not, you know, this is my choice. And I'm bringing, I think I'm bringing happiness to people. So it's simple as that.
Madonna climbs 4 spots from number 19, where she debuted last week. Video song number 15 is Lucky Star. Madonna at number 15 this week. In the middle of November, Madonna's going to go on the road for the first time with a full band. Coming up, Chicago's latest makes a jump on the countdown, and they say they know more about video than you might think.
The MTV Top 20 Video Countdown.
9 weeks in the top 20 for Night Ranger's latest, falling from 10 to 14. This is When You Close Your Eyes. For their first video, Honeymoon Suite went to director Chris Terry, a film teacher at Ryerson College in Toronto. But the band says that 70% of the concept was their own. New Girl now moves up from 14 to this week's number 13. Even though Chicago have been together for 15 years, they shot their first video just a few months ago for Stay the Night. Still, they know what they're doing.
For years, we did films that are now called videos, but used to be called convention films. And either we would take a piece of music from an album or else do a montage of music and have a scenario written, make like a 10-minute film. And in essence, it is basically what we do now for videos, except now we're just concentrating on one song and really trying to flesh out the story of a song or the imagery of a song.
A strong jump of 5 spots this week for Chicago's latest, up from 17 to number 12. Hard Habit to Break. Video song number 11, up from last week's 15, is Sheila E. Leading the Glamorous Life.
Welcome back to the MTV Hall of Winners, a collection of people who really won. There's Charlie Wellick and Audrey Zelenko and Patty Giarusso. And here's MTV Beach Party winner Colleen Sullivan with Kenny Loggins.
Well, you've been a wonderful contestant. Now it's time to play You Bet Your Life.
And Kurt Jeffries on his MTV Lost Weekend with Van Halen.
This just goes to show that you really can win.
The MTV Top 20 Video Countdown.
John Waite has been at number one on the countdown for 7 weeks. And in just a bit, we'll see if he can make it 8 weeks on top. This weekend, Billy Idol's in Italy playing at the annual Lake Garda Festival. Also on that bill, Spandau Ballet, Tina Turner, Wham, John Waite, and Howard Jones. Billy's going to be performing Eyes Without a Face, which just entered the Italian charts. And here in America, his latest video song makes a jump of 3 spots, up from 13 to 10. It's Flesh for Fantasy. Dropping out of the top 5, down from 5 to 9, Scandal with The Warrior. The number 9 video song in America, The Warrior. Now up next, Lindsey Buckingham on his own and with Fleetwood Mac. Ever since he joined Fleetwood Mac 9 years ago, Lindsey Buckingham has been the band's progressive spirit. The more experimental album Tusk in 1979 was primarily his concept, and to this day, he prefers music outside of the mainstream.
In other words, when Fleetwood Mac was going strong, it wouldn't have made a lot of sense for me to sit down and listen to the Eagles, you know? So what I do now, I listen to things that are to the left of what I'm doing, because the whole ethic of the way I approach music is that you must take risks. It's very important not to rest on your laurels. It's very important to move forward, or at least move somewhere.
In his solo material, Lindsey also likes to take risks, and he says that he tries for depth as well as accessibility.
What happens a lot of times is you get albums of material that you listen to once or twice, and you know, you've blown your cookies on it. That's about it. So I think it's important to challenge the listener slightly, to make them grasp for it a little bit.
He's now released 2 solo albums, and he recorded 1 song for the soundtrack of National Lampoon's Vacation. While Lindsey would like to go on the road, he doesn't think he's got enough material yet to support a solo tour.
I have another album all worked out in my head, so I would like to, as soon as I'm done, you know, doing the follow-up for this, I would like to jump back in the studio and follow the Go Insane album up, you know, with something right on its heels.
Lindsey's success as a solo artist, as well as Stevie's, Christine's, and Mick's, leaves one question. What's become of Fleetwood Mac?
We have not broken up, certainly. I think it's pretty up in the air. It's on hold. We will do another album at some point. I think it's just everyone seems to be off in, you know, a million different directions right now, and it's pretty much just a question of working out the logistics. And I, you know, I would not want to think of us doing an album for the wrong reasons. So when it appears that the reasons are right, I think we'll do it.
You can see the rest of that concert taped during Fleetwood Mac's 1982 Mirage Tour, Saturday, October 13th at 11 p.m. Eastern. And in the meantime, Lindsay's at number 8 on this week's countdown, down a spot from 7. Here's Go Insane. Go Insane, video song number 8. At number 7, it's Cyndi Lauper. And when they remember 1984, they'll remember not only Cyndi's sound, but her look.
I think that as far as style and fashion, I guess I had no idea what it was what my video was going to do to that. I did the best I could with what I had and opened up my jewelry box and went to town. I've always hated other people telling me what I had to wear, and so I guess I was always a bit of a rebel. I never thought that anti-fashion would catch on and become fashion. So it's a surprise.
Shebop slips from 6 to 7 this week. Here is Cyndi.
The MTV Top 20 Video Countdown.
We've got the hottest video songs in America. Friday night at 11 p.m. Eastern, 10 Central, and Saturday afternoon, 4 Eastern, 3 Central, 9 p.m. in Britain, where this week three songs debut in the top 10. Coming in at number 10, A Letter to You, the new one from Shaken Stevens. Alphaville slipping a spot to number 9. Black Lace in at number 8 with Agadoo. And a big leap from 22 up to number 7 in the UK for Bronski Beat and their latest Why. And David Bowie's got the highest debut at number 6 with Blue Jean. Wham's George Michael spent 3 weeks at number 1, and he's at number 5 this week. Lost in Music from Sister Sledge climbs 3 spots to number 4, featuring backup vocals from members of Duran Duran. We got U2's Pride in the Name of Love moving up to number 3. And this week's top 2 are the same as last week, with Ghostbusters hanging in there at number 2. And for the 4th week in a row, Britain's number 1 song is I Just Called to Say I Love You from Stevie Wonder.
I just called.
Not only is David Bowie's latest number 6 in Britain this week, it's also number 6 on MTV's countdown. Next Friday night at 9:30 Eastern, by the way, you're going to see the 20-minute film that contains the video, Jazzin' for Blue Jean. It's directed by Julian Temple. But this week, Bowie climbs from 8 to 6 with the first video from the album Tonight. This is Blue Jean. David Bowie with number 6, Blue Jean. Right now, David's in Switzerland working on a video for This Is Not America, a song that he co-wrote with Pat Metheny for the movie The Falcon and the Snowman. To complete the video, he may go on location to Mexico, South America, and England. A few weeks ago, John Waite set the record for most weeks at number 1 on MTV's Countdown, and he's extended that record to 7 weeks. But this week, Missing You has fallen out of the top. Last week's number 1, this week's number 5. Here's John.
Slim, rich, Loris Quartz. No. MTV asks, how many eyes do you have on your face?
2.
Good. How many ears on your head?
Let's see. 2.
That's right. How many dollars in your pocket?
2.
Yep. And how many speakers on your TV set?
Just 1. A crummy little tinny one.
What's wrong with this picture? Call your local cable company. Get a stereo hookup and experience the full rich sound of your favorite video music. MTV Music Television.
In stereo.
The biggest jumper of the week in the top 20 is the first hit for a band who have paid their dues. John Cafferty and the Beaver Brown Band have stuck together for more than 10 years, mainly playing clubs in the Northeast. John thinks it was definitely worth it.
The reason that we formed the band and the reason that we've stayed together for so long is it's really the only thing that I ever found in my life that gives me a way to relate to myself. It's the only thing that I really feel right doing. I don't really know how to do anything else but be a musician. Not that I couldn't do something else, but it's really what I know how to do in the way that I feel the best.
A leap of 7 spots from 11 to number 4. This is On the Dark Side from John Cafferty and the Beaver Brown Band. John Cafferty and the Beaver Brown Band. With John Waite dropping out of the top spot, that means a new number one video song. 3 more to go, and we'll get to them right after this.
Are we ourselves? A question to ponder during the commercials.
On this week's MTV Top 20 Video Countdown.
The Fix have begun their North American tour, and this weekend they're playing in Toronto and in New London, Connecticut. Their latest video continues its climb up the countdown, moving up from 4 to 3. Are We Ourselves from The Fix. It's the 4th week at number 2 for The Cars. They hold their position once again with Drive. The Cars idling their engines for 4 straight weeks at number 2. Last weekend, The Cars played to a packed house at Wacomico High School Auditorium in Salisbury, Maryland. It was the last date of their American tour, and before the show, I talked to Rick Ocasek about the band's plans.
I think we're going to Europe. Well, I know we're going to Germany to do some TV around the 20th of November, but we might as well go over to Europe as well. So I think we'll play over there a bit. And that'll be it. Then I'll be on to a solo record.
There's a brand new number one video song, and we'll tell you who managed to knock John Waite out of the top spot right after we take a look at a couple of Scandinavian number ones. In Finland, Lionel Richie's on top with Hello. And in Norway, Stevie Wonder is on top with I Just Called to Say I Love You. And back at home, MTV's new number one comes from Prince. Let's Go Crazy, the second video song from Purple Rain, a movie that almost got an X rating. Some scenes had to be edited in order to get an R, but Prince's co-star says the film never went too far.
I always say I was brought up with a rosary in one hand and a belt in the other, you know. I practice Catholicism. My parents are very strict. My parents have love and understanding in anything that I do. I wouldn't do anything that was demeaning to myself or Susan and Brenda, my group. I wouldn't do anything that lacked class. To me, it was very sensual. You keep it, you know, concealed to one's eye. And I thought it was a very good taste, which was very important for the film.
From the number one album in the country, the number one video song in the country, Let's Go Crazy from Prince and the Revolution. Let's Go Crazy, our new number one on the MTV Top 20 Video Countdown. And Prince has also now made it 2 weeks as champ of the Friday Night Video Fights. This week we saw debuts in the Top 20 from Sammy Hagar and Crocus, and big moves from Chicago and John Cafferty. Now, next week, we could see new entries from Donna Summer with There Goes My Baby, and Billy Ocean with Caribbean Queen. Also, Prince is going to try and hold on to number one for a second week. You'll see what happens Friday night, 11 p.m. Eastern, 8 Pacific, and Saturday afternoon, 4 Eastern and 1 Pacific. I'm Mark Goodman on the MTV Top 20 Video Countdown.